In many ways, the name Frances Shine is synonymous with the League for the Blind and Disabled. As executive director for 25 years, Frances left her footprint on the future prosperity and growth of the League. Since its inception in 1950, the League has evolved and grown exponentially. Frances Shine was instrumental in growing the League and bringing to the forefront the needs of the blind and disabled.
A Centers for Independent Living grant became available, first time ever in the country. And the federal legislation said that states had the first right of refusal. States could take this grant and administer it, and they get the first shot at it. But if they didn't take it, the federal government would contract directly with nonprofit agencies. Frances saw that coming, and she wrote that first grant to the federal government for the League to become a Center for Independent Living. And she got that grant. She treated everybody like gold, and that was my impression. A classy woman who knew how to take care of the people around her.
She was a wonderful person that represented our agency well. On the way to some of our meetings, Frances and I would be discussing our families and our children. And she stated to me on one occasion that she was very proud of her children and they all made her happy.
Frances didn't talk a lot. She's a tremendous listener. And when she did talk, everybody was listening. She had a love for this League and she never lost it.
As I recall, Frances was one of the people easiest to work with. There was one thing about Frances that I've always been thrilled about, that she had a wonderful feeling about blind people and their abilities. I don't think she thought of them as being disabled. She thought of them as capable people. I don't think being at the League for the Blind was a job. It was the way she carried out her mission to the world. She was always ready to be whatever help she could be anytime we needed. Frances was a godsend to the blind in this area.
While Frances immersed herself in the daily activities of the League, she also balanced it well with her personal life. Frances has four surviving sons, Robert, Thomas, Larry, and Steve. Each were devoted to her as she was to them.
She was, as I say, very traditional in the sense that until she started working with the League, she was an at-home parent, at-home mother, and everything in the house ran so smoothly. She dedicated herself to, she was a great cook, great loved to cook, and was a wonderful preparer of meals. And there were no fast meals in those days. I mean, you sat down and everything was beautifully done and completely done.
Frances Shine was talented in many ways. She was an accomplished pianist, and she loved to cook.
She was not somebody who got involved in your business except when it came to cooking. She would say, if she were at my house when I was cooking, she'd say, well, I wouldn't do it that way. I do this instead. One day I was in Indianapolis for business and called her on the phone, and she said, well, what are you going to have dinner for the kids? She was worried that I wasn't going to get home in time. And I said, yeah, I've got something on the stove or something like that. And she said, well, how did you make it, or what did you do? And I told her, and she said, oh, I don't think you should have done it that way. It would be much better if you did this. And when I got home, I saw her car in the driveway. I thought, what the heck is going on? I go in there and she's finishing the dinner because she didn't think I was doing it the right way. But all with the best intentions, all, you know, generated by feelings of love and warmth for her family. That was her.
But she's the person who set this agency free. And then with the vision to leave an imprint on us, Frances Shine is the matriarch of this organization.
I've said it before, but her dedication to blind people, to their needs and to their ability. There are so many who can look back through the years and be thankful they met Frances Shine because she did such wonderful things for them.
Beautiful and gracious. She would be humbled and thrilled that the League is focusing on her accomplishments at this time.